Hey everybody, what's up? This is Epic Technology, and today I'm going to be talking about Ido Bachelet, an assistant professor who's made a very big claim, which could have startling implications for the future of medicine. In a short announcement video online, Ido claimed that they had received a test subject who had volunteered to undergo a series of trials using medical nanobots. These medical nanobots are DNA-based and can target specific cancer cells in the body. Ido claims that using these trials, the patient may be cured within 6 months. So what are medical nanobots, and how realistic is this claim? Nanorobots are machines designed to work on the nanoscale. In the past, they were considered more a part of science fiction. However, more recently, they've been accepted into the scientific community. Currently, however, they're only used in experimental and theoretical models. Nanomachines have a wide variety of applications and uses, but in the DNA-based nanomachines in this particular experiment, they're going to be used for targeting cancer cells and delivering specific kinds of drugs into them. The nanomachines have many more uses as well. For example, there are many drugs that are considered unusable and too toxic for humans, but are extremely effective at killing cancer cells. The reason why they're not used is because they also kill other cells in the body, since they have very poor targeting skills. A nanomachine, on the other hand, would be able to take the drugs into itself and then deliver them around the body and deliver them to very specific parts of the cancer cells. And by using this method, they could very directly kill only the cancer cells and make these drugs usable, and also to use other drugs for other applications. The claim is incredible, with the prospect of being able to use a whole new variety of drugs with extreme precision and guaranteed results. But how much weight does this claim actually hold? While this announcement did come as a casual announcement, Ido Bachelet has been working on creating nanorobots for killing cancer cells for many years now. It was only this year in April that DNA nanorobots were used in the cockroach to interact and deliver different kinds of nanorobots all around its body. In the article, Ido said that there was no reason why they couldn't start human trials soon, showing that this research has been going on for quite some time. However, big futuristic advantages do usually happen gradually over a long period of time, and whether or not this claim turns out to be larger than life, nanorobots will still arrive eventually, whether it takes decades or a few more years still. However, we will just have to wait until 2015 to find out if these results really do come as intended or not. So what do you think of nanorobots? Are they something that interests you? Leave a comment below with your thoughts, and thanks for watching.